Hi, I'm Kara Price, and this is Talk Nerdy to Me, the HuffPost science show in which we boldly go where scientists have gone before. You may or may not think about this on a daily basis, I certainly don't, but the Earth is extremely old, like 4.5 billion years old. Think about how many Law & Order SVU reruns you could watch in that time. Probably not all of them. To keep track of this long history, scientists created what they call a geological timescale. This is like a Facebook wall for stuff that has happened in the history of the Earth. Within this scale, we have eons, eras, periods, epochs, and tupochs. No, I'm kidding, we have just epochs. Our current epoch is named after a Bon Iver song, the Holocene Epoch. The Holocene Epoch started around 11,700 years ago as the Earth exited the Ice Age and began a period of warming. You may have realized that since then, there has been an explosion of human activity. I don't just mean that we merely inhabit the Earth, but have been adding onto it with the good, the bad, and the criminally insane. With this in mind, many scientists are proposing that a new epoch has begun, and they call it the Anthropocene.
So the Anthropocene represents a chapter heading. It gives us a way to label the human influence on the planet. This is a chapter break. This is a time when the natural system ends and the increasing influence of human activity continues and amplifies in the future.
How do we know we've entered the new epoch? What are the telltale signs of the Anthropocene?
Just think about pollution. Just think about our nuclear bomb test from the late 40s until the 70s. Those released radioactive elements into the environment, and those are circulating in the atmosphere and the oceans and the plants and our bodies today. So that's one very clear man-made marker.
Since the mid-20th century, other human impacts include our massive release of fossil fuels, our use of plastics, and our use of fertilizers. How does this man-made change compare to major geologic events in the past?
One of the really central tenets of geology is that the Earth has been punctuated by five big extinctions. They're called the Big Five.
Big Five. Isn't that a basketball thing?
These were times when something like more than 50% of all life on Earth became extinct. So these are not only chapter headings in Earth history, but these are fundamental new books. Most recent one was the extinction of the dinosaurs. These extinctions are big deals. There's very good evidence that what's happening right now is what's called the sixth extinction, the human influence on biodiversity. We are unquestionably influencing the environment, and in my opinion, we are unquestionably leaving a permanent mark in the geologic record that were some future society to come to Earth and see us a million years into the future, there would be absolutely a marker that defines us. The fact that we're making a mark on a whole planet carries with it a big responsibility to reverse course.
But we have time, right?
Got about 10 years to turn this thing around.
10 years, I'm not feeling great about this.
I'm actually really an optimist about the future. There's an energy revolution that happened in the United States that almost no Americans are familiar with. The cost of producing a unit of electricity from fossil fuels versus the cost of producing it from renewables crossed over 2 years ago. Now the price is cheaper producing energy through renewables.
All of this feels so abstract.
Very few of us are motivated to do anything about climate. If we look at global mean temperature rising or sea ice decreasing or even polar bears, I mean, they're very emotional issues, but they're not really affecting you as a person. If the sale price of my home is decreased because of sea level rise, I want to know that. If my box of Wheaties is going to cost three times what it cost me last year because of a drought that's impacting the rain belt, I want to know that. If I can no longer have water in my home in the western United States because the reservoirs are going dry, I want to know that. These are all things that shape our relationship to the environment, and they're all in flux, they're all changing.
What the introduction of the Anthropocene as an epoch tells us is that we must change our behavior on a daily basis. And just like we made this mess, we can also clean it up. But the clock is ticking. But in the meantime, I'm going to Costco to get myself a lifetime supply of Wheaties.